Hello everyone, and thanks for being here. My name is Radu, and I've been working on oxygen XML editor for the past 15 years. And as any application which has lots of functionality, oxygen has lots maybe of hidden features or features that you do not normally use in your daily work. And this presentation is about those features, I guess. As you all know, you can drag and drop side views in Oxygen to rearrange them. And besides docking side views, you can also auto-hide side views on the left bar, if you want to gain space, to gain editing space. But, you know, sometimes after you drag and drop a lot of side views, you end up not knowing what the original default was. So one thing I'm using quite constantly is to, you know, reset layout. So you press the reset layout and the side views are rearranged again on the side. Usually when I'm giving a presentation and I have limited screen size, I double click the tab of the topic, and all the side views are automatically hidden on the left and the right sides of Oxygen. This can also be done from here, like maximize editor area, and the side views are on the left and on the right, and you can hover them to access the functionality. Maybe sometimes you just want to hide the toolbars. So you can go to Window, Hide All Toolbars, which is a new Oxygen 22 functionality. Click that, and now you have more screen space for your editing. If you want to keep using the toolbars, you can customize them. You can right-click, configure toolbars, and then maybe remove the toolbars which are useless to you. There are also some toolbars which are not enabled by default, and I think one of the useful toolbars is the symbol toolbar. So the symbol toolbar allows me to insert custom symbols in the editing area. I place the caret, and then I can insert these mathematical related symbols, or I can look for more symbols in the character map and insert the symbols from there by double clicking. You probably have used the project view and the data mask manager and so on, the outline view, which are common views. Maybe there are some side views that you have not used before, like the information view. So this side view, let me enlarge it a little bit. It shows me the schemas used to validate a certain XML document. So if I have an XML document and I validate it, I can see exactly what Oxygen did in the background. Like it used the default DTD validation with the Oasis DTD because it's a data topic, and then it used the schematron validation, and then a data specific validation, and so on, and then it reports what problems were found in the end. So if you don't really know what Oxygen does to validate a topic, you can show the information view. The properties view is a view which shows you the current set of properties for the XML document, for the current open XML document. The name of the file, line separator, the path to the file, the encoding of the document, what type of vocabulary it is, size and indentation, format and indent line with the associated CSS file size on disk and so on. So you may find this useful at some point if you don't know how much space the file takes on disk. If at some point you find yourself copy-pasting a lot, we have the scratch buffer. And what this does is that you can use it to store content inside it. So you copy-paste content to the scratch buffer. It's just an area of text. And then you can take this content out and copy-paste it back where you need. So maybe it's a temporary buffer in which you store the content between copy-paste operations. The Oxygen project is quite useful to organize your topics and your files. And maybe you're not yet using Oxygen's master file support. So what this does is, let's say I have a Dita project and I enable Oxygen's master file support. And then I can say that I want this Dita map to be a master file. And then whatever change I make in the Dita project, like if I change the name of the folder, any change that I make will be made in the context of the master files. So Oxygen will detect the change and apply the change and refactor all the links to the change files.
Probably that file is from a different location.
Possibly, yeah. So sometimes I may get a bunch of XSLT style sheets from somebody and I do not know which are the master style sheets, so which are the top level style sheets. So then you can say detect master files and you can find all the master XSLT style sheets and this will help you to validate XSLT modules. Let's see, so maybe I can click this one, finish. And I will have this as a master file. And then for XHTML5, whatever document I open, it will be validated in the context of the master file. Other things that you can use with a project. So you have a project opened in the Oxygen project view. And then you can go to the options. On most preference pages have the possibility to save them at project options level. So if I want, for example, I can go to the spell check page and I can say, okay, save to project options and save. And this means that the project XPR file now contains, sorry, it's my daughter. you can say that the project XPR files now contains the spell check information inside it. So now I can take the XPR file and share it with the rest of my team members. And everybody who will open this XPR file will have the same settings applied when they are editing. For example, for the Oxygen XML blog, if somebody opens the blog.xpr, they get a bunch of project level settings here. Like all these checkboxes are saved at the project level, the document type associations are loaded from a special frameworks folder, spell check, and even custom dictionaries lists specific to your project. Moving further, can compare files by selecting them in the project view. If I have, for example, two logbook files, so I go to samples, logbook, maybe I want to compare to similar logbook files, I just select them, right click, compare, and the Oxygen's visual comparison will show me the difference between these two files. But I can also select two folders, V4 and V5, right click, compare, and there should be a directory comparison tool showing me the differences between these two folders. The directory comparison tool can also be accessed from the tool menu. Coming back to the project file. What else can you do with the project? You can apply batch actions on your entire set of content. So I can apply check spelling in files, and the spell checker will check all the files in the folder, and all the spell checking options or all the spell checking problems will be shown in the results view. I can apply validation on the entire set of folders, transformation if I want to publish multiple files, and I can also format and indent files if I want to apply Oxygen's pretty print or XML formatting to a number of files. On the project toolbar you have a filters view, and here you can decide what files should be hidden. Maybe I want to hide all PDF files, and I click OK, and there was a PDF file which is now missing here. So if you have files which are not important for your project, maybe they are backup files, you can use this filter toolbar action to hide them out. If I double click images in the project, they are open in the Oxygen image preview. And now if I navigate in the project, I think I just edited an image. I'm using Oxygen with Java 11, so I have the image preview, and now I can select one file or another and the image preview will get updated. So if you have images in a folder, use the image preview to look through the images and see what each image does. Tool that I wanted to be implemented was, let's say you have a folder somewhere in the project and you want to run a command line in that folder. So you right click and say show in terminal, and a terminal is opened at the precise location in that folder. And then you can run some various scripts. Another thing that I use quite often is to right click and say show in Finder or show in Explorer on Windows, and the Finder is opened and it shows me the exact place similar to what the project showed me a couple of seconds ago. How do we navigate between files? So we have multiple files opened in Oxygen. How do we switch between them? So in the window menu we have commands for next and previous editor. It's command F6 on Mac. So you say command F6 and then you can you can navigate through the opened documents. And then you have command shift F6 and then you can navigate backwards to the documents. You can use our open find resources view. So you go to find, open find resource, and now you can find resources by file name. And all the resources are searched in the entire project context. So I can open this resource here directly from the open find resource view. The open find resource has multiple features, like I can say searching content, and then I search for topics for XML documents containing various keywords like iris, like autumn, and so on. So I may find these topics and then open them, and I can see highlighted the words which have been found in the current opened XML document. And also with the open find resource you can search in reviews. So if you use change tracking in your project and you have made insertion and deleted comments, insertions, deletions and comments, you can see all these changes appear here, so that when you double click you open the topic, and the topic has these comments here, and instead of just searching manually for them, I just use the Oxygen's open find resource functionality. Sometimes you may want to see where an XML document is located on disk. So you right click and say show in Finder, and the Finder or the Windows Explorer will open and show you and highlight for you the current XML document, and then you may maybe copy it and paste it in an email and so on. Also here you can find actions to copy location and maybe paste it somewhere else, or to reopen the last closed editor. If I close some tabs and then I regret and I want them back, I can say reopen last closed editor and so on. Reopen, and the last closed files are reopened for me to edit. We have a toolbar menu here, like go to the last modified content, backward and forward, which again allow me to go backward and forward in time to the last visited XML documents, or to go to the last modification. This is useful when you make changes in one place but open other other XML documents, and then you want to go back to that particular place where you made the changes. You click this and then you can go to the last modification. Maybe you're in another file, click this, and you go to the last modified content. Yes?
Can I move to the last modification in the same document?
You go to the last modification in whatever document, so it doesn't remember per document. It remembers globally the last modified file. You cannot say go to the last modification in this document and then to the last modification in that one and so on. You go globally to the last modified file where it is. So the find replace functionality. You have find replace in files, and you can use it on the project. Search for various pieces of content, and you have restrict to XPath. So you can say, I won't only want to search in paragraphs. So once you click this, Oxygen will find you matches only in the paragraphs. And avoid finding matches in other elements, like this info element. Sometimes in XML, if you use format and indent, the text may split in a paragraph. Let's say I want to search for detail the support, and I have no idea the text is split on two lines. How do I search for it? So I can go here and say, find replace, eliminate the restriction, and the text to find, I place these words as if they would be consecutive, and then I say ignore extra white spaces. So I check this, find all, and the Oxygen found the match although the content was broken on multiple lines. So if you search for sequence of words and you do not know if maybe they are on multiple lines or not, you check the ignore extra white spaces property in the find replace in files dialog. Or you can just use Oxygen's open find resource and search for the words here. Searching content, and it may find multiple matches. Moving on with the find replace functionality. If I select a word and I want to search for the next occurrence in the current file, we have find next and previous actions. So I go to find and I say find next, which is command G, and then I say command G and gets to the next, and command shift G and gets to the previous occurrence of the word. Or you can select the word and use command shift F, and Oxygen will show you all the matches of the word in the current document. So you can see the shortcuts here, find all, command shift F. There is a quick find toolbar that few people know about. So the problem with the find replace dialog is that it's huge. So you have it on screen and you search with it, and it actually covers the content you are searching. So you say find, and then you say, okay, move on the side. You know, it's a dialog and it's large. So in the find dialog, you have a quick find action. And this is the quick find toolbar. And it resembles the one in Firefox, for example. So you can search using this toolbar. And it has limited functionality. Next, previous, all, incremental search, case sensitive, and so on. From it, you can also open the larger find replace dialog. But also you can find with XPath. So I can perform an XPath in all the selected project resources. So I can say find me all paragraphs, and and the paragraphs will be searched for in all the files in the V5 in the V5 folder. So with XPath you can also search for expression like find me all comments which contain to do. If, for example, you mark various sections of your XML document, like I need to revisit this, and then apply the XPath on an entire folder, and then you will have the matches available for you. Moving on to the...
One question,
yes,
about XPath search. Is there a way to search through a specific path on your file system when you use the XPath search?
So what I would do would be to go to the project and say add folder.
Yes.
And add the folder there, and I could then run the XPath on the selected project resources.
Mm-hmm.
Or I can say working sets. And then I define No, my custom folders here. So I define this working set, and then I can say search in this current working set.
Where did you set up the working set?
So I say.
The setup of the working set. Wait.
Sorry.
It's under configure expat.
Ah, it's right there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, configure expat working sets, and then you can define your own set of folders on which you want the expat expression to run. Text editing. So let's switch to the text editing mode if we are talking about text editing. Removing the quick find panel. By the way, if you are using quick find, the toolbar, and it appears here, and you want to get rid of it, you just press escape, and the toolbar disappears from here. So what I would usually do when I make presentation is that I can use command plus and command minus to increase or decrease the font size. So this might be a useful thing for you if you want to increase the font size for a particular period of time. Sometimes when the document doesn't fit the horizontal space, you can right click and say toggle line wrap, and then you have visual line wrap, meaning that all the lines will visually wrap to fit the available horizontal screen space. What else? You can use sometimes when you're editing in a text editing mode, you want to see maybe a vertical line showing you the overflow. Like I can go to the text editing mode. I go to the text editing mode and I say I want to show a print margin of 80 characters. And once I show it, I have the margin shown here, so maybe this helps me not to overflow the current line of content. If I'm manually typing, you know, I type and then, you know, type, and then as I'm getting near the print margin, at some point I can, you know, break the line and continue typing on the next line in my file. Code templates. So code templates are small snippets which get expanded by Oxygen. Like for example, I can use a code template for the selection, and then I can define it in the Oxygen preferences. I can say bold, and the content is B selection. This means that I would surround the current selected content in a bold element. So I define this code template, I click OK. Now it's here. I select text, and control space, and I can see the bold code template here, invoke it, and the current selected content was surrounded in bold. And in code templates you can use editor variables, like I use the selection editor variable. You can use the author name if you want the editor variable to be expanded to the name of the current user logged in into the system. You can use editor variables to ask the end user for feedback. So this is the ask editor variable. So I go back to my bold code template. I say bold ID equal and paste my ask editor variable, and I say here ID value. So what happens is the next time I invoke the same action, control space bold, Oxygen will ask me for feedback to fill the ID value. I fill the value here, and now it appears in the expanded XML snippet. You can also use in code templates other more complex editor variables like expat eval. So in this case, this is an expat evaluation. Make an uppercase from the current file name, but only the first three letters. So this is quite an ingenious scripting language in which you can expat code templates and have lots of functionality inside them. And also these code templates can be saved at project level. So if I go here, you know, I can say switch to project options, save, and now I can share my code templates with my colleagues. I would usually, if I want to select an entire element in the text editing mode, I would usually triple click the tag name. So triple click the end tag on the start tag, and now I have the entire element to copy paste, drag and drop, and so on. If I want to move lines up and down, I can use Alt up and Alt down. So I can move lines like this. If you click to the on the line number on the left, you can select the entire line in the editing area. If you have a go to dialog in find, go to, and then you say the line number 166, or maybe an offset in the document, and Oxygen places the cursor position there. So Oxygen places the cursor here. If I want to open a file, like here I have a reference to a web resource, I can use command enter, and the web browser opens, and it's a broken link. Yeah, so whenever you have links in Oxygen, like this one, a command enter, and Oxygen takes you to the target file in that particular situation. Sometimes you may want to add bookmarks. So you go here on the side and click, and you added a bookmark. And you can click in multiple places, add bookmarks here, add bookmarks in another file, and so on. And then if at some point you close the file, you can use command 1 to open the file at the specified bookmark, like command 1, command 2, and navigate between my bookmarks. Most side views have a quick find filter, like the outline view. You can search for section and you can find only the sections that are defined in the document. What else? Let's try to drag and drop a file in another XML file. So I drag and drop this file here, and Oxygen inserts for me a relative reference to that file. So if at some point I want to say xref, href to a file, I can just drag and drop the file here, and now I have the relative reference to that file inserted inside the href. Yes.
How to beautify the part of code or the whole text?
Sorry?
Beautify to make it compacter.
Let me see. So we have this format and indent. Do you want to, for example, to decrease the indentation in the entire content? For example, I would select two list items and then use Shift Tab to move them to the left, or Tab to move them to the right, maybe. I'm not sure if that's what you're asking.
And the indent size that you can modify on format and indenting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, also. You can go to the format and indent page and say, I don't want the indent to be detected, I want it to be zero. And what happens is that I will probably regret this. No. So everything moves to the left. And then, of course, if I want my indentation back, I can, you know, define another indent size. Maybe I want it one. Okay. Use again the toolbar, and now I have one indentation. So between the parent and the sibling and the child, there is one space. If at some point you want to insert a reference to an image file, but you want the reference to be embedded in the document, so I can say something like image href, and I want to say that it's an embeddable reference, and then I right click and say source base64 encode, import file to encode, and then you can where is that file? So source base64 encode, import file, let's find a file somewhere, maybe in the Oxygen XML blog images. Let's pick a file, you know? And now the file is percent encoded in your XML document. And if you switch to the author mode, it actually presents the file. Also the publishing works. If at some point you want to have an XML file containing everything inside it. And let's switch back this monstrosity. If it wants to be switched back. So, what else did I want to show you? You can escape or unescape the selection. If I have a small piece of XML content, like A, B, and I actually want to insert it inside the code block. So I have a code block somewhere, and I insert this here, but I don't want to insert it as XML because it's an example. So I can say source escape selection, okay, and now it's all escaped as and it's a, no, it's an example, it's not actually XML tags. So in the author mode I can see it like this, and this is how it will get published with tags. Let's say you have an area where you have comments and list items maybe, and no, other kind of things. If I want to add a comment around this area, I will just select it and say toggle comment. And what's nice about it is that it escaped the illegal characters inside the comment. So now I have toggled the comment on the entire section, and then I say toggle comment back, and I obtain my original content. So I can take an entire section, right click, toggle comment, and now it will no longer appear in the published output. Let's say I have a huge file and I want to copy paste from one part of the file to another. And I can go here to the window section and say split editor vertically. And what happens is that Oxygen shows me the same file opened in two side views. So if I make a change somewhere, the change will be reflected in the right panel. Or if I make a change here, it's reflected on the left. And now I can copy paste content between these and copy paste it here, and the content was is updated in both side views. So when I save in only one place, but I can have multiple views over the same XML document here. And then I can say window, unsplit editor, and I'm back to normal. Sometimes you may want to see two XML documents side by side. So you can say window, tile editors vertically, and now you have these two documents side by side. You can decide in which editing mode you want to have them. And maybe you can copy-paste content between these two opened XML documents. And when you are bored with this, you can say stack editors. And now everything is back to how it was. I may have an XML document, and I may be in a certain section or in a certain XML tag, and I want to see the DTD grammar or the XML schema grammar which is used to validate this tag. So I can say go to definition, and Oxygen takes me to the DTD where the element section is defined. And this works also for XML schema and the RelaxNG. So if you don't you want to work on a vocabulary side by side with the XML document, this is useful for you to navigate between the XML document and the vocabulary, the DTD or XML schema on which you are currently working. I think we're done with the text editing mode. Some of you don't know that in Oxygen you can open very large XML documents. So if I have in my downloads page, at some point I open up. Okay, so I have this document here. Let's see how large it is. So it's 1 gigabyte and a half. So it's an enormous XML document. I double click it, and Oxygen says, I'm warning you, you should use the loading for huge files, otherwise you will get an out of memory. So I use the huge file support, continue, and the file is opened, but it is split in multiple chunks. So you cannot read the file from one end to another. You need to navigate these chunks here so that you can read portions from the file. So this is the huge file editor. You can find replacing it, and you, if you search for a word which is not found in the current chunk, the chunk is incremented. You can even save content in it without Oxygen encountering any out of memory problem. So you can modify chunks and then save. It will take a long time because it's 1 gigabyte, but you save and Oxygen will save the content back to the very large file. The grid editing mode is a mode we added for XML documents which are usually exported from databases. Let's see if I have an example of how this would look like. So if I have this, for example, this personal XML which has these person elements and they are repetitive, and maybe they were generating from a database like a dump, and then I can go to the grid mode and I can see all these repetitive elements as rows in a table. And what I can do in the grid mode is that I can copy paste content. And I can paste it in, for example, in an Excel spreadsheet. And I get this content pasted like in a matrix. So I paste the content and I get this matrix here. And I can also take this content from here and paste it back. And it overwrites the content in the current table. So if you had these kinds of XML documents, maybe the grid mode is something that you should try out. So here you have text, grid, and author, and this is the one in the middle. In the author editing mode, again, you can increase or decrease the font size using command plus and command minus. If I want to insert elements, I usually press enter, and I see a list of elements. And what I like about this is that if I want to pick an element which is not available at the current position, like a list item, I cannot insert a list item inside the list item, and Oxygen says the element is not valid, but I will choose a position for you. So press enter again, and Oxygen has broken the original list item in two and inserted the list item in the middle. Again, when you press enter, you can find the already defined code templates available inside, and they work. So I select content here, press enter, use the bold code template that I previously defined, enter, give an ID, and a bold element has been inserted around my selection. So I have a code template defined in one place and used both in the text and in the author editing modes. What else can you do in the author editing mode? If I select content, I can press enter and surround it in a tag. Or I can select only the star tag, press enter, and rename the tag to some other tag. So enter is a quite a versatile mode of working with the author mode. You can select multiple intervals, like select a word, another word, and another word, and then say edit profiling attributes, and set a certain profiling attribute on all these selected words. Or select the words and say bold, and all the words have been made bold and have been surrounded in the bold element. If I want to edit attributes for a certain element, I can use the attributes side view. So I can see the attributes for each list item, for example. But I would usually use the in-place attributes editor. So you press Alt Enter, and it's an in-place editor showing me the available attributes if I want, or allowing me to set an ID attribute, for example, on the current list item without using the side view. If I want to select an entire element, I just triple click it inside the content and it's selected, and then I can move it around. If I want to expand the selection word by word, I double click, and now I'm expanding the selection going word by word. So double click and then drag and drop with the mouse to select word by word instead of selecting character by character. If I want to move elements like paragraphs or list items up and down, I use the Alt up and Alt down functionality, which is similar to the one in the text mode. If I have a list item I want to increase its indentation, I press Tab at the beginning and I'm indenting the list item, or I press Shift Tab and the list item moves back to the original location. My colleague Christian already showed you how you can use our new feature for autocorrect support. Like, let's say I have a paragraph somewhere, and in the paragraphs I say one dot, press space, and Oxygen has created an ordered list for me. Or I can say a note, colon, space, and Oxygen has created a note element for me. And this is configurable at framework level. You define your small pieces of content and say that they should be replaced with this XML fragment. So if I want to comment out a list item, I just triple click to select it, right click and say toggle comment. Where is it? So triple click or do like this and say toggle comment is somewhere, I don't know where. I think it's command slash, no, command command T.
Yeah.
Oh. Command shift T.
Yeah.
No. It should have worked in the author. I'm using it quite frequently, but I'm not sure what's the problem in this. I have no idea. The action is just missing right now. I will look into this. So we have a missing action. How about if you have a paragraph and you want to count the number of words inside it? So you select text and you say count words. And Oxygen will say that you have 34 words in the paragraph. Or without the selection, maybe you can select the entire content and count the number of words in the document. Maybe this is useful if somebody tells you write an article with 200 words. You need to know where to stop, right? Or sometimes you may select content and say, I want this content to be converted to uppercase. Or I want this content to be converted to capitalized words. Maybe this is a title and I don't want to manually capitalize the words in each word. The author mode also has a bookmark area, and again you can add bookmarks to it and then use command 4 and command 5 to navigate between the bookmarks. Then you can remove the bookmarks when they are no longer necessary. In this particular example, I have lots of sections and I can say collapse other folds, so you have folds in the author mode, like in the text mode, which allow you to collapse content, but you can say collapse the other folds, and what happens is that now all the other sections are collapsed and only my section is expanded, so I can focus writing in it, and then I can say expand all to go back to the original way of writing. Again, in the author mode, you can use code templates, and I showed you this. You can use editor variables in code templates, like the author name, selection, open dialogues for the end user. The outline in the author view also has a quick filter. And one thing that some people don't know is that the author mode is the best solution we have right now for editing a bidirectional text with Arabic or Hebrew content. So if you have Arabic content, it's displayed on a right-to-left direction directly in the author mode. And I can work with it, you know, as usual, bold content. The problem with the text mode is that it's hard to maintain the right-to-left the right-to-left flow of the text when you have tags with English names inside, like B. So you have Arabic and then you have B, and the text mode gets confused because it doesn't really know how to sort the Arabic words around the B tags. But the author mode knows. So if you have a colleague who does writing in Hebrew or Arabic, they should use our author editing mode and not the text editing mode. If you have never tried this before, you can open Word documents in Oxygen. So let me find some samples. So I have this Word document, double click and it's opened in the Oxygen archive view, and then double click the XML document. and you either have this monstrosity of XML content, or you can go to the author mode, and we have a CSS which presents it in a way similar to how Microsoft Word does in their tool. And we have some the same functionality, I think, for LibreOffice. So if you have a Word document and you do not have Microsoft Word, and you know, you may open it in Oxygen and switch the XML document to the author editing mode. We have lots of options, and I think one of the popular option is the one for changing the color theme in Oxygen. So at some point we added support in the appearance mode to change the color theme to graphite. So if you're somebody who likes dark themes, you can use the graphite theme. We have quite a lot of clients who seem to appreciate this theme. Let's say you have reordered Oxygen side views, and you want to preserve the layout. And then you can go to window... Oh no, not that one. You can save the layout, and then you can say export layout, and the entire layout, like the set of toolbars and side views, get saved to a layout file. And then you can say in the options preferences that you want to use a custom layout. And then you navigate to the layout file and open it. So you can save a layout file containing the arrangement of side views and toolbars to a file, and then have everybody else use the same file if you want to impose them or on them the arrangement of the toolbars and side views. What else? I kind of use the fonts editing mode quite the fonts preferences page quite a lot. I'm usually using Oxygen on a Windows machine, and sometimes you get content which is not in English, and the author mode may not know how to display the content. And then you need to change the font. And you get to the fonts page, and then you search for a font appropriate for your set of characters. And we added a checkbox recently which says show only the fonts that can render the sample text. So you can click this checkbox, paste your characters inside, and this is filtered out to eliminate the fonts which cannot render the characters in the editing area. On Mac, in a way, people on Mac are lucky because there are lots of fallbacks, so whatever font they choose, they will somehow be able to edit Arabic, but on Windows, this is not the case. On Windows, if you have Arabic, you need to go and choose a font which can support Arabic content. The spell checker, as I showed you in the Oxygen blog, you can go and say I want to have a custom set of dictionaries for the spell checker, because I don't want the spell checker to report as mistakes my product names. So you create a file with all those product names for one line, and then you tell the spell checker, okay, these are the names which are no mistakes, so do not signal them as errors. And also, usually the spell checker is disabled, so the first thing I do after I install Oxygen is to enable it, because I'm not a native English speaker, so I make mistakes when typing. But probably everybody does that. We have an external tools preferences page, which allows you to define command lines. Like maybe I want to define a ping command line and ping and define the command line here. Click OK, And once I define this command line, I can find it here. I can press it, and Oxygen started, executing my command line in this console view. And then I can stop it when I no longer want to ping Yahoo, in this case. So in the editor save preferences, you have a couple of options which you may find useful. So you go to the editor save, and you may choose to automatically save the current document every couple of minutes. Maybe you have crashes on your computer, maybe your computer is not stable and you want to save on the local disk. You may want to save auto-recovery information every 1 minute or 2 minutes or 3 minutes or so on. This means that even if you don't save the file, the next time Oxygen starts, it will tell you that it has auto-recovery information for that file, and it will help you recover the contents of the file. You may choose to validate the document before saving. If you want to disable saving if the document is not valid. As Christian showed in his previous presentation, whenever you have an XML document with an associated CSS, besides viewing it in the author mode, you can say new XML to PDF transformation with CSS, and then apply the transformation, and you will get a PDF based on the XML and CSS. So here's the PDF. It looks like the author mode, but it's in a PDF format. The Oxygen Chemistry engine was used for this particular trick. You should at some point investigate our tools menu. It has lots of functionality, like convert XML to JSON and the other way around, invoke XML refactoring actions on lots of resources. If you want to convert content, we have a possibility to convert between HTML and XHTML. You can use our batch converter add-on to automate the conversion of multiple files. For connectivity, Oxygen offers a subversion client, so you can collaborate on a subversion repository. You can work directly over WebDAV repository or exist databases. There are other add-ons which add connectivity, like the Git add-on in Oxygen that I'm using here, which allows me to pull and push content from a Git server. The CMIS add-on allowing me to connect to any CMIS aware database, or the basics add-on created by Accepta, which is a company from Germany. So check out the add-ons. The most useful add-ons you will find in the help, install new add-ons, and the default update site. So you select the default update site, and Oxygen will show you a bunch of add-ons which are officially created by us. And then you can select and install the add-ons in Oxygen and enhance its functionality. If you want to keep in touch with us, you do not need to write us emails. Most people go to help and... or some people go to help and say, report problem. And then they write some content to us. And then they hit the submit button. And then we receive an email. And then, ideally, when you report a problem, you should also leave your email here, because if you don't leave us your email, we cannot get back to you. This is not a chat box. So if I write something here, the Oxygen team will not write back in the same dialogue. But we will receive an email. And along with that email, we receive various information from the application, which might help us determine the problem. If you want to send us XML content and the content is sensitive, you do not want to share the text content with us, so you can use the support tools randomize XML content. Support tools, randomize. Should we randomize the current file?
Yeah.
Let's go for it. Here we go. So the file no longer has sensitive content. You can send it to us, and because most of the time we do not care about the text content, we care about the XML structure. Most problems are in the XML structure. Attributes are missing, and so on. So you randomize the file and send it to us. Let's see if undo works. Oh, yes, it did. We have lots of tutorials available. We have the Oxygen XML blog. And on the Oxygen XML blog, you can find the same tips and tricks article that I presented to you. So if you want to read them again or give links to your colleagues, you can find the same functionality described on the Oxygen XML blog. This is what I wanted to cover for today. Do you have any questions for me? Yes.
Yeah. We are working on projects, different people at different times, and I was thinking about having the XPR file as part of our Git repository together with all the data, and so that the next developer can kind of take advantage of the transformation scenarios the previous developer included. But then I noticed that for every file that I had opened and I executed a transformation scenario, that is stored in the XPR file, and so I would have to kind of have these XPR files as part of my repository always being changed by everybody. And have I overlooked something, or is there a more clever way of handling this, that the, how is it called, the scenario associations are kind of stored locally only?
Yeah, so we had lots of people asked us about this. So in Oxygen 22, we decided to do something about this.
Great.
So we have project level settings. This is a new page. And here you can say, don't save the transformation scenario associations at project level. So you uncheck this checkbox. The transformation scenarios are still saved at project level, but not the associations.
Mm-hmm.
Because the associations were volatile. You would open an XML, and in the XPR you had a reference between the XML and the scenario. So with Oxygen 22 you uncheck this checkbox. And actually it offers you a lot of control about what gets saved at XPR level to make it less volatile.
Right. So I didn't miss it?
No.
Today, so.
Well, the release was yesterday, so.
Yes.
Yes, Nico?
If I validate on the directory in the project view, sometimes I have their files inside, the images, which have no associated schema.
Mm-hmm.
And if I make the batch validation, I get a lot of error messages that there's no schema or that they cannot be validated. Is there something what I can do for it?
Maybe you could try before validation to apply a filter. So maybe you could say directory filter patterns, maybe filter out some folders and or some file patterns not to appear in the project, and then the validation will skip over them.
Okay.
Maybe
you create a project with these filters.
Yeah.
I have an additional question to the project file. The project tree is stored in the project file, and now we are shipping. XPR file with our Oxygen framework, but users have their own project trees. They just work with project trees and have their own file in it. And now when they have an update of our framework, the XPR file is overwritten, and so is the project tree. Is there any possibility to install the project tree? Otherwise I didn't notice it in the new panel.
Yeah, so I don't have a solution for this, but how about if you commit on Git only the original XPR and then tell everybody to duplicate it and start from it as another XPR?
Yeah.
So that would be the template XPR that they would take and create their own.
We are doing kind of that, but
so you want to somehow separate the options part of the project from the reference to the folder.
That would be a good idea.
It's an interesting idea. Well, maybe you could impose the options in some other way, like we have the possibility to impose options in Oxygen with an add-on.
Yeah.
So they install a plugin and the plugin imposes settings in Oxygen.
Oh, I see. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So in this way they would just not use the project for that anymore. But the add-on would mean to be hosted somewhere on your website, and they will go like help install new add-ons, paste the reference to your internal website, install the add-on, restart, and then they have the settings there available.
But the project tree only keeps, if you have like a real folder, it only keeps a link to that, not to the content of that folder, unless you duplicate that with logical folders, let's say.
Yeah, I know.
So
maybe the team members add other folders to the XPR.
Yeah, because in our case, basically we just usually we add the we have only one entry, which is the folder that stores the project file as the project tree.
Yes.
So it's only dot the current folder which is added in the project.
Yes.
Yeah. Again, the project file. This is a fascinating beast, and I always have to look up which. I have to press the shift key if I want to open it as an XML editor or some other key. I can't remember that. But the paths are usually stored relative to whatever. So, but how great would it be if they were kind of stored relative to the project directory? That would make kind of portability.
Mm-hmm.
It would increase portability between operating systems and etc. So that is the kind of, they could all start with dollar, what is dollar PD or something mm-hmm. like that?
We do that for some of the paths, but not
yeah.
for all.
Yeah.
So if you have an example, maybe we could do that for that particular case
okay.
also.
So in some cases, we automatically detect that and we
mm-hmm.
replace. Even if you set the absolute path, we replace that with the relative
yeah.
one. But usually for many of the options, you can use the editor variables manually.
Okay.
If we do not do that, you can just replace with the dollar curly brace project directory or project directory URL. And if it's a URL.
Now with this new option, I'm going to reevaluate that again.
Okay, thanks for listening. And I'll now invite my our end user, Christoph. And, Christoph, thanks for agreeing to present for the last session of the day. Thank you.